کے ناظرین فوری خبر آپ سے شیئر کریں. وزیراعظم عمران خان ڈیووس میں عالمی میڈیا کانفرنس سے خطاب کر رہے ہیں.
افغانستان which wants peace after 40 years of conflict is Pakistan, because we get directly affected by what happens in Afghanistan. The tribal areas which border Afghanistan have been devastated in this since after 9/11, the war on terror. It devastated those areas, and we feel that the only way we can rebuild those areas, we can give employment to the youth there, we can sort of rehabilitate their shopping malls and their houses, is if there is peace in Afghanistan and there's trade between the two countries. And of course Afghanistan is an economic corridor right up to Central Asia, so it's very important that there is peace there. And the only difference so far was that the US believed that there was some military solution, and I for one always opposed this military solution. I always believed that this whole war on terror was the wrong way of fighting terrorism. I felt that it created more terrorism because of collateral damage. We were witness to that in our own country, in Pakistan's tribal areas. The more drone attacks, the more people got killed, their families got killed in drone attacks, the more people joined the militants. So I was opposed to this, and for that I was considered anti-American. I was considered someone who was pro-Taliban. So finally the US policy under President Trump is that there should be peace talks, and there should be a dialogue, and there should be a political settlement. So we came on the same page, and that's why I have a good relationship with Pakistan has for the first time a decent relationship with the United States, because relationships are built on common objectives. Previously we had this awful situation where the US expected Pakistan to help them win the war in Afghanistan. Pakistan should never have accepted this challenge by the US, because we could not do it, we couldn't deliver. And so our governments made the big mistake of agreeing to the US what they couldn't deliver. As a result, we were reviled. We lost 70,000 people dead in this war on terror, and at the end we were held responsible for the US not succeeding. Now objectives were same. Both the United States, Pakistan, Afghanistan want peace. It was just a question of how to get the Taliban talking to the US and then to the Afghan government. So this was the main subject. Others were, of course, we want trade with the US. Pakistan wants help from the US in improving our trading relationship, which was previously was just a transactional relationship, Pakistan to help the US in the war on terror, and US gave us aid. Now we want a proper relationship with the US.
The last time you met, President Trump suggested he might be willing to get involved in Kashmir. You've called to internationalize the issue before. India, of course, has always opposed it. Is there any chance that's going to happen?
Let me just say one thing. You know, when my government came into power, I am a firm believer that, you know, military is not a solution to ending conflicts. In fact, you go into a conflict with one objective, and then it spawns various other unintended consequences, and other conflicts come out of it. So from day one, you know, I believed that the only way forward was we have peace, we try to have a peace settlement and help the US peace settlement with Afghanistan, mend our fences with Iran, because there were some border issues we had with them, which we did, and then the next was India. And India, you know, I have to say that I'm probably the one Pakistani who I feel knows India much better than anyone else. I have probably more friendships than anyone else in India, and because of cricket being such a big thing in India and Pakistan, and because of that cricketing background, I felt that I was ideally placed in improving our relationship between the two countries. So immediately I reached out to Prime Minister Narendra Modi, And I was amazed that there was, it was, the reaction was quite weird. Because, you know, we thought, you know, we said we all our differences, which is mainly Kashmir, we could settle through dialogue. But, you know, the subcontinent hosts the greatest number of poor people in the world. And the best way to fight poverty is to have trading relationship between the two countries rather than spending that money on arms. So this is what I spoke to the Indian Prime Minister. But, you know, I came across a brick wall. And then really the events that happened, this suicide attack on in Pulwama in Indian side of Kashmir happened. Indian soldiers got killed. I immediately told him that if you can give us any actionable intelligence, we will act. But rather than act, they bombed us. So one of the Indian planes came down. We immediately returned the pilot, again saying that, you know, this is two nuclear-armed countries cannot afford a conflict. But really, it was after Mr. Modi won the second election, which was in 2018. And then when he annexed Kashmir, Kashmir, remember, is a disputed territory between Pakistan and India, according to the UN resolution 70 years ago, the 11 resolutions of the UN. And the people of Kashmir were supposed to decide their destiny through a referendum, a plebiscite. So India unilaterally annexed Kashmir, revoked their status, which was in their own constitution, this Article 370. And from then onwards, things went from bad to worse. And really, what is happening in India, let me just say one last word on that, because I know India, I think it's a disaster for people of India. It's a bigger disaster for people of Kashmir, who for over 5 months now are literally in an open prison, kept there by 900,000 troops. It's a disaster for India because India is a multicultural society. It was the vision of Mahatma Gandhi and their first Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru, which was a secular society. And with this this philosophy, this ideology of Hindutva, which is the RSS philosophy, which was inspired by the Nazi when it came about in 1925, which believed in the Hindu racial superiority, and also was built on hatred against other races like Muslims, Christians. So therefore, I feel bad because, you know, how can in such a huge country with a Muslim population of 200 million people, there are Christians there, there are Sikhs there, there are Dalits there, there are tribals. I just think that the path which India is going is a disaster for India. But I feel that for people of Kashmir right now, it is the biggest disaster because they are trying to change the demography of Kashmir, which actually is against the Fourth Geneva Convention, calls it a war crime. So, yes, I'm worried about Kashmir, and that's also what I talked to President Trump about.
So you said a lot there that I want to pick up on. First, to return to India and Pakistan and the idea of war.